Hi there, my name is Prosper Azone, and today we're going to be unboxing these bad boys. I've got here with me, move to the side, nigga. I've got here with me the Apple Pencil as well as the 2021 iPad Pro. Now, look at this stuff.
This guy needs no introduction.
And a couple of other accessories that I felt like would be necessary to boost the whole experience. So we have here a screen protector and a case. I'm not going to be going through the specs. You know, I got the 256 gig iPad 12.9 Pro. That's as much as you're going to get, because there's really no point going into the spec. So let's jump right into it.
So this is it. I got the 256 gigabyte. Like I said before, I'm not so concerned with the spec, because if you can draw on paper, then drawing digitally shouldn't be a thing of, you know, trying to figure out the best tool, but just figure out one tool that makes it work. I'm saying that I should just pretty much just say that this is not my first iPad Pro. I used to own the 2018 version, but I sold that to be able to get this. And the reason why I sold that is not because it's not as decent as this, because that guy too is a beast. Like, trust me, that stuff is still standstill. But I sold that pretty much just to be, you know, future proof, you get, so at least I can make use of this for the next 2 to 3 years without any, you know, any need to want to change it even more, I guess, even more. So yeah, this is it. Wow, this is so, peeling this thing off is so fulfilling. You have no idea. You need to do it yourself for you to be able to tell. It's so damn fulfilling. Yeah. Sleek. So I got the brown, the gray one. My previous iPad was also gray. So it's cool that we're, you know, paying respect. So this is everything that is in the box, just the charger and the cord, pretty much all you need. I honestly think Apple should, you know, include the pencil. I know most of us, the reason why we get this stuff is it's just to be able to draw on it, and it would make a lot of sense if maybe they both come together. But I know all of this stuff, they are business, so obviously they want to do something that will favor them. But let me tell you something that you might not even know. My iPad has been with me for more than 2 weeks now. This is the third week that this iPad has been with me, but I did not even bother to unbox it because the pencil came in late. The pencil only came in last night, so I was like, oh, what's the point? Why would I unbox this stuff, and what would I be doing with it when the pencil is not here? So the pencil came in yesterday, and then I couldn't wait anymore. I just had to do this today. This is the Apple Pencil. Amazing stuff. Finally. So the next thing I got to unbox is the pouch. So this is the particular one I got. It's not like the best out there, but I just needed something that would hold my pencil and the iPad together, so I don't have to place one elsewhere and be looking for it. So I don't even know what it feels like to not have the both of them together, like I said. So that's why I went for this particular casing. For the screen guard, I'm not going to unbox that today. I don't, like, even on my previous iPad, I made use of that stuff for over 4 years, like a decent amount of time, and I didn't put any screen protector on it. So for one, the reason why I got it is because I know for sure that, man, this stuff is expensive. You wouldn't want to play rough play. But there's a thing about screen protector. Once you don't have a protector on, like also in my iPhone, because I don't have it on my iPhone, if you don't have your screen protector on, you're less likely to throw your phone away, because you'll be very conscious. But when you do that, you don't even think about things too much. So I feel that's how it is here. But I got the screen protector aside from the fact that this stuff is very expensive. You don't want to even play that nonsense play with it. The main reason is because I just want to see how it will feel like drawing on the screen protector. So that's the reason why I'm not going to unbox the protector now. I'm going to use this for at least a week or two to see how it feels, and then I'll put the screen protector there and compare. If it's better without the protector, then I really don't mind. I'm going to take off the protector. But if it's better with it, then that's a plus. Alright guys, thank you very much for sticking around till the end. If you're interested, I'm going to make a follow-up video sharing my experience. So if you're down for such a thing, do hit the follow button. Stay tuned till next time. See you guys.